Hi guys, good morning. How are we doing? It's Sunday. Arthur's barking out loud. I've got another hacking day happening today. I finished it at 1 last night, this morning, and woke up at 5:30 maybe this summer. It's the last day of January in 2021. Surreal, right? The first month of the year is at its brink. And it's gone pretty fast, but time seems to have stood still, because we're still hitting extremely high numbers here in Malaysia. Yesterday we clocked the highest so far, so I think we've achieved 3 of the highest numbers we've had in just January of 2021. That's not a good thing. It might be more, actually. It might be wrong. Correct me if I'm wrong. But yeah, that's crazy. We are almost at 6K new cases a day. What to do? Life goes on. We're still an MCO. Movement Control Order 2.0. And this is my daily lockdown chronicles. I decided to start it the moment lockdown happened, and we're 19 days in and I'm still going strong. Good thing, bad thing, I don't know. I ramble on about things that happen in my life, and hopefully some of them can be good takeaways. Yeah, so what will be February still to come tomorrow, and my plans, I've decided to take them by the horns. Because according to the lunar calendar, this year, this coming year, the lunar calendar year, is the year of the bull. So I am going to take the bull by the horns and navigate my goals and aspirations. So my plan is, previously has always been, set a goal for the year and then hope that it gets done. But this time around, I'm starting to review it every month, if not every week. Some may think, what you mean you change your goals all the time? It's not so much that, but keep them in bite-sized chunks, so that it's more palatable, it's more chewable, it's more digestible, and it's more logical and achievable. So yeah, I'm going to be proactive and plan ahead, reviewing what I set out for 2021. See what I've done in the past month and what steps to take next, what's working, what's not working, blah blah blah. So yeah, I just don't want to set something and say, okay, I'm gonna do this, and then rush into it but never achieve it. So what's in store for that for February, for me at least? Better videos, I hope. Maybe I put in some flair, but that's not the top priority. My top priority is to get the videos done on a daily basis, at least for the next month or two. If I do it for 3 months straight, then maybe I'm onto something, you know? But better videos also mean not just for fun and laughter like this, but also for work. And I'd like to bridge the gap. I'd always do one or the other when my passions override my work. I feel guilty about work. When my work overrides passion, I feel guilty about putting too much time in passion. Sorry, you know what I'm saying? No. Okay, let me rephrase that. If I put too much emphasis on my passions and my hobbies and stuff like that, my work suffers. And vice versa, if I put too much time on my work, life becomes a bit more mundane. So one good thing about me personally is my work is quite fun. Can be tedious, but quite fun. And there's a bridge. But sometimes I don't lower the drawbridge. I don't try. I feel like I shouldn't connect them because it feels like too much fun. But this time around, I'm like, hey, you only live once. Connect the dots. Make this stronger, and make this stronger. Why not, right? So, yeah, I want to be more involved in community projects as well, if not just participate in them. I want to initiate them and manage them. One of which is something I do with, I'm part of the Graphic Designs Association in Malaysia, and I started, we've been silent for a while, and I kickstarted the conversation with everybody again, with the committee, and we're going to lay out some plans, and hopefully they'll get done. If anything at all, we'll get together virtually. And yeah, so those are small things I can do, I feel, and do more with my art, my photography, my music, and collaborate, not just do things on my own. I can do things on my own, but at the end of the day, I need to collaborate, because it can get lonely, and it can get tiresome if you do everything on your own and you not get far. As you know, the saying goes, if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. I think that's what it says. So yeah, this will be my 19th video. Again, I hope to improve and explore funky ways I can juice this up. But it's not just for this. Whatever I learned here, I'd like to implement it in my work life and systems that, and strategies that I put in place in my work life, or in experimenting with my work life, I'd like to put in place into my passions, so that they both get some traction, they both progress at the same time, and not fight for my attention, time, and headspace. So yeah, I guess nothing should go to waste. I would have to recycle, reuse, and reduce. How so? Okay, recycle the knowledge that I've learned and apply it over and over again. Okay, that's one, recycle. Reuse that knowledge by teaching others. Share, you know, so that when you teach, you actually learn and you sharpen the knife of what you know. And reduce the time of having to experiment and fail too much. You still experiment, you still fail, but I'm experimenting systems in my passion, my work systems in my passion, and I'm experimenting techniques in my passion on my work. So this way, I sharpen the sword faster, I gain the skill faster, I become an expert faster, I implement faster, and I learn what works and what doesn't work faster. Again, I'm not trying to rush into things, but more so not waste time or use time better, I guess. That's what I'm trying to say. So yeah, I think that's a useful takeaway, if anything at all. So here's to another month. Here's to February 2021, Chinese New Year, Valentine's, and a lot more stuff is happening. We've just had Taipei 7, the first in Malaysia, Kuala Lumpur. We're going to have Federal Territory Day. I need to check if we've got a day off or not. Either way, I'll still be working. But I'm wishing everybody the very best. Stay safe. Mask up. Keep a distance physically, but stay connected. See you guys tomorrow. Take care. Bye. This is Viv from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, for a vivid world.